Hey friends, Ash here with Gen Sense, coming at you guys with a triple header review. Three different fragrances today. We've got Pinot Silvestre, Perfect Gentleman, Pinot Silvestre, Modern Dandy, and Pinot Silvestre, Deep Charisma. This video is dedicated to Serapio Silva and the No Pause Wow group on Facebook. So, shout out to all you trolls out there. Keep on trolling. In this video, I'm going to go over these fragrances. I'm going to try to keep this kind of serious, even though it's three Pinot Silvestre fragrances, but we're going to try to keep it serious. We'll also check out a little bit of the presentation. I'll break these down for you guys and let you know what I think about these fantastic cheap fragrances. And surprisingly, actually, one of them I do kind of like. So stay tuned for that. At least one of these is okay. Not bad. So let's jump into this. Let's check out the presentation. I only pulled two boxes out. These two right here, Deep Charisma and Perfect Gentleman. They are the... Let's go ahead and check out this presentation really quickly. I pulled out two of the boxes. So you can see them right here, Deep Charisma, Perfect Gentleman. The design and everything's the exact same, just the coloration is different. And obviously, fragrance name on the front is gonna be different. Their Eau de Toilette concentration, 125 mils size, nothing on the sides. Then on the back, a little bit of info on the fragrance, including the ingredients and a little information on the house itself here. And these are actually from the Pinot Silvestre selection. So each one of these three fragrances are kind of supposed to be, I guess, higher end Pinot. Made in Italy, as the bottom of the box will tell you. And then your batch code is down there as well. And then the bottle is going to be in your Pinot Silvestre sort of pine cone style. You've got the name of the fragrance on the little sticker here on the front. Atomizer right there built into the cap. Not a particularly good atomizer. There we go. Just like a little puff of fragrance. And these are prone to a little bit of leakage from underneath the atomizer cap here. And this does not come off. Ooh, slick. And then on the bottom, you have a sticker with your batch code. All right, the first one we're gonna talk about here is Modern Dandy. Obviously, each one of these is supposed to be putting across the feeling of a gentleman, hence the name, Modern Dandy, Perfect Gentleman, Deep Charisma. They're trying to put across the feeling of somebody with money, with power, with influence. And I guess the fragrance is supposed to convey that as well. But with Modern Dandy, when you first spray this one on, you get a nice pungent alcohol blast. Very nice. Burns the nostrils a little bit if you smell it right away. So that's great. And then after that, it starts to remind me a little bit of Nachos Bel Grande from Taco Bell. Yeah. So I worked at Taco Bell for a couple years ago, back when I was younger. And for whatever reason, I don't think it actually smells like Nachos Bel Grande, but after that alcohol really cinches the nose hairs, that's what it reminds me of. Yeah, so not awesome, unless you like smelling like that. But thankfully, it only lasts a short amount of time. And it's really this powdery violet with this weird herbal spiciness. And somehow, some way, that combining together, what makes me think of that? And I gotta say, it just does not really work for me, especially in the opening. It's not a thing of beauty. It is not Modern Dandy. It just has this weird green-ish vibe and nothing feels well put together. It's just kind of muddled, like just thrown together in this haphazard, messy kind of way. That's how this comes across in the opening. Thankfully, after 15 minutes or so, it starts to settle in. A little bit of sweetness starts to creep in and it starts to smell a lot better. And that's going to be coming mainly from labdanum. So it's this warm sort of sweetness and then this woody, spicy, aromatic kind of combo comes together, starts to work together a lot nicer, and it starts to smell like an actual fragrance. So that's through the mid, and it still smells pretty cheap. It doesn't smell at all like one of those hidden gem fragrances or a cheap fragrance that actually smells expensive. It smells like what it costs. It smells pretty cheap. You've got some balsam fir that comes out. You've got some lavender, some rosemary. So you've got these different things popping up, and it makes the fragrance, again, smell better, little more aromatic, but still really not all that good. More a spring and fall kind of fragrance, daytime or nighttime fragrance. The opening is horrible. The opening is terrible in this fragrance for me. I just don't like it at all. Through the mid and the dry down, it's not too bad for a cheapie. It's okay. But the opening sucks so much that I really can't recommend it. And as far as performance goes, not great. And really none of these are great performing fragrances. It peters out about 45 minutes in, so you're not gonna get really great projection for a long time. And when it is projecting the heaviest is when it's just a complete mess. In terms of longevity, 3 to 4 hours for me. So Modern Dandy, obviously not the one of these three fragrances that I actually like. That's actually probably my least favorite of the three. The opening there is just really bad. It's kind of a catastrophe, an abomination. Yeah, not good. Next up, let's check out Perfect Gentleman. Look at that quality. You can spin that all the way around. You can spray this from 360 degrees. You just don't see that in fragrances very often. Now, of course, you're gonna have to deal with a leaking atomizer and fragrance getting all over your hands after a couple sprays coming from underneath here and from right here, but look at that action, 360 degrees. So this one opens up, smells cheap. Again, cheap kind of vibe going on. Smells better than Modern Dandy though. So that's a positive. It's got citrus and spice off the top and the synthetic lavender, but it smells okay. It's got like a little bit of a watery facet to it, kind of sharp at times, and green. The sweeter, slightly powdery base notes are noticeable pretty much right away as soon as you spray this one on. So it's gonna be mainly sandalwood and a little bit of tonka. That's what I pick up. So that's where you're gonna be getting that little bit of creaminess and sweetness in here, different from the labdanum that you're gonna find in Modern Dandy. Now, here's the issue with this fragrance. About 5 or 10 minutes in, the green vibe in this scent starts to go off kilter a little bit. It starts to get kind of sour. And I think it's from the heliotrope and the bay leaf notes in here. Could be wrong, but that's how it comes across to me. It starts to fall apart a little bit, 5-10 minutes in. So whereas Modern Dandy opens up and in the first 15 minutes, it's just a train wreck. This one opens up and it's pleasant. I mean, not anything that's gonna blow you away, but it's pleasant. And then things just start to fall apart at the seams a little bit. Thankfully though, that only lasts about 10 minutes. So it's kind of as it's transitioning from the opening into the mid, it doesn't do it smoothly. It's like a DJ mixing songs at a club. You know, if you do it correctly, then it goes from one to the other and you never really notice. It's very smooth. This is like a train wreck happening in a DJ set where just everything falls apart. It doesn't match. Things are just out of rhythm, out of beat. And it sounds horrible. That's kind of what's going on with this fragrance. From the opening into the mid, it just goes and falls apart. But then once it makes it into the mid, it's okay again. This one's gonna be centered more on floral notes, so lavender and heliotrope. Once it makes it through that messy period to the mid, the heliotrope actually smells okay for a cheap fragrance. There's also a soft iris in here. Obviously, it's not gonna be a real iris note, but there's a soft iris in there as well. And tonka in here is also really prominent. So that's where you're gonna get the sweetness in this fragrance, especially through the mid. It really comes through and you pick up a whole bunch of it. It also has kind of an almondy facet to the scent, like an almond sort of vibe, nuance. And if I had to guess, that's probably the heliotrope mixing with the tonka. Overall, not too bad once it hits the mid. That period from the opening into the mid, not good. Not good at all, but once you hit the mid, not too bad. It does smell slightly less cheap than Modern Dandy. Performance is a little bit better than Modern Dandy, but still not really good. Still looking at 4-ish hours longevity, 45-ish minutes projection. So there's Perfect Gentleman, a little bit better than Modern Dandy, but still not really all that good. And that brings me to Deep Charisma. This one is the one I actually like of the bunch. It surprised me. It's actually really not that bad for a cheap Pinot Silvestre fragrance. This one is much more herbaceous, much more green than the other fragrances in the line. It's got a big dose of cypress that you can pick up right away, and a good dose of rosemary as well. This also has thyme in there and even a note of tea. And in the opening, this one blew away the competition. This was the last of the three that I gave a proper wearing to, and it was far and away the best. In the opening, it's just immediately apparent that the things in this fragrance are actually working together. It's like there's an actual idea here, and they just decided to take it and make a very green, woody, herbaceous fragrance, and that's what they did. These other ones, I'm not exactly sure what they were trying to do other than trying to make something sophisticated. Now, if you don't like cypress, you don't like green fragrances, you probably won't like this one. But if you do like cypress, if you do like woody, herbaceous green fragrances, and you're looking for a very inexpensive one that you can add to your collection, check it out. Even from the atomizer, this one destroys the other fragrances. It's not even close. It really is not close, in my opinion. I legitimately like the tea note in here. It gives like a little nuance, a little change, a little twist to your more typical green woody scents. The lavender in here is prominent. The lavender in here smells much better. It smells less synthetic than the one in Perfect Gentleman, though obviously it's not a natural lavender in a fragrance this cheap. It still comes across much better, more pleasing than the one in Perfect Gentleman. It's green, fresh, aromatic, a touch powdery, but actually surprisingly, a really solid cheapie. And as of right now, if I could have only one Pinot Silvestre, toss the rest, it's this one. Deep Charisma. That should be a tag video. Keep one Pinot Silvestre, toss the rest. So Serapio Silva is the one that obviously led me to purchase these fragrances, and he led me to the hidden gem that is Deep Charisma. And I know some of you out there probably think I'm joking and that Deep Charisma sucks, but it's actually pretty good. I mean, for this price, yeah, I have no issues with that at all. I'm actually glad I bought it. The other two, Perfect Gentleman, Modern Dandy, no. But Deep Charisma, yes, please. You'd probably tell actually by the labels, it gets progressively darker. This one is the richest of the bunch, the nicest of the bunch, and these are just kind of meh. And there we go, guys. The Pinot Silvestre selection of fragrances. This video has been a long time coming. Now it's finally done. All right, guys, if you smelled these fragrances, let me know what you think about them in the comments below. As always, thanks so much for hanging out with me today. Thanks for all your support, and I will see you guys tomorrow with another fragrance video. See you guys.